Belinda presents this unabridged recording of The Palestine-Israeli Conflict, A Beginner's Guide, written by Dan Cohn-Sherbok and Dawoud El-Alami, and read by Richard Aspel. Preface to the third edition. Over 7 years ago, this book was first published as the Palestine-Israeli conflict intensified. In the second edition, published in 2003, we discussed further events that had profoundly affected Middle East politics. In particular, the terror attacks on the World Trade Center and the Pentagon had focused international attention on the significance of the struggle between Israelis and Palestinians. In the subsequent 4 years, major events have taken place in the Holy Land. Prime Minister Ariel Sharon suffered a severe stroke and was replaced by Ehud Olmert. Yasser Arafat died, and Mahmoud Abbas was elected president of the Palestinian Authority. Israel launched an offensive against Hezbollah, and, most recently, Hamas won the majority of seats in the Palestinian Legislative Council. Today, there is a major struggle between Hamas and Fatah for the hearts and minds of the Palestinian people. This revised version of our book highlights these most recent developments while presenting a history of the struggle between Jews and Palestinians for the land of their ancestors. Dan Cohn-Sherbok, Dawoud El-Alami, 2008. Preface to the first edition. During recent years, the conflict in the Middle East has exploded onto our television screens. Day after day, images of violence and suffering have dominated the news. Scenes of heavily armed Israeli soldiers facing young Palestinian children hurling stones with slingshots, like Goliath facing David, have evoked dismay and confusion. The vehemence of the Palestinian reaction is a result of years of pent-up anger and frustration. The Israeli response has been swift and determined. Palestinian towns have been besieged, territories sealed off, and negotiations suspended between the Israeli government and Palestinian representatives. What are the causes of this bloody conflict? Is there any hope for peace in the Middle East? These are the questions that this book seeks to explore. Designed for the general reader with little knowledge of the modern history of the Middle East, this volume is unique in its approach, offering both a Jewish and a Palestinian perspective. Nearly all studies of the Arab-Israeli conflict are written by a single author, but here, two differing accounts are presented from a Palestinian and a Jewish scholar with widely divergent views. Dr. Dawoud El-Alami is from a distinguished Palestinian family. Born in Jerusalem, Dr. El-Alami was educated in Egypt and graduated from the University of Cairo with a degree in law. Initially, he worked as a lawyer, only later becoming an academic. Over the years, he has held appointments at the University of Kent in Canterbury, the University of Oxford, Al-Albayt University in Jordan, and the University of Wales, Lampeter. An ardent advocate of the Palestinian cause, he is critical of both Israeli and Palestinian policy. Professor Dan Cohn-Sherbok is an American rabbi who was ordained at the Hebrew Union College Jewish Institute of Religion and later obtained a doctorate from the University of Cambridge. He has served Reform congregations in the United States, Australia, Britain, and South Africa, and is currently Professor of Judaism at the University of Wales, Lampeter. He has written a study of Israel, Israel, the History of an Idea, in which he advocates the creation of a homeland for the Palestinians. Nonetheless, he is a strong advocate of a Jewish state in the Middle East. In their presentations, both authors outline their history of Middle East politics, beginning with the origins of Zionism in the late 19th century. They adopt different perspectives about the same historical events. For Cohn-Sherbok, the creation of the State of Israel was an urgent necessity, given the terrible history of the Jews in Europe. In his view, the Holocaust provides ample justification for the establishment of a Jewish nation. El-Alami, however, regards Israel's claims to Palestine as lacking any legal or moral foundation. Angrily, he protests the Jewish appropriation of Palestinian land. In his opinion, Israel must compensate the Palestinian people for nearly a century of hardship. In the concluding chapter of this volume, Cohn-Sherbok and El-Alami debate the central issues of the Middle East crisis. The aim of this study is thus to encourage readers to gain an informed understanding of both the Jewish and Palestinian viewpoints, and to come to their own conclusions regarding the troubled and turbulent history of this part of the world. Dan Cohn-Sherbok, Dawoud El-Alami. Chronology. 1862. Publication of Rome and Jerusalem by Moses Hess. 1881. Assassination of Tsar Alexander II, followed by persecution of Russian Jews. 1882. Publication of Auto-Emancipation by Leon Pinsker. 1882-1903. First Aliyah. 1891. Arab protests against Zionist settlers in Palestine. 1894-95. Alfred Dreyfus falsely charged with espionage. 1896. Publication of The Jewish State by Theodore Herzl. 1897. First International Congress of Zionists. 1903. Persecution of Jews in Kishinev. 1904. Beginning of Second Aliyah. 1905. Seventh Zionist Congress rejects alternative to Palestine as aim of Zionism. 1908-09. Arab opposition to Zionist settlements intensifies. 1914-18. First World War. 1915-16. Sykes-Picot Agreement. 1917. Balfour Declaration. Arab Revolt. Lawrence takes Aqaba. Allenby enters Jerusalem. 1919. Chaim Weizmann leads Zionist delegation at Paris Peace Conference. 1919-23. Third Aliyah. 1920-21. Arab anti-Jewish riots in Palestine. 1924-32. Fourth Aliyah. 1929. Arab riots in Jerusalem, Hebron, and Safed. 1930. Parsfield White Paper seeks British disengagement from the Jewish national home aspects of the Balfour Declaration and the Palestine Mandate. 1931. Irgun Save Lumi established. 1933-35. Fifth Aliyah. 1937. Peel Commission recommends partition of Palestine. 1938. Evian Conference. 1939. Conference at St. James's Palace. White Paper repudiates partition and favours an independent Palestinian state. 1939-42. Cooperation between British forces and Jews in Palestine. 1942. Loss of Struma. Biltmore Congress. 1943. Anglo-American Conference at Bermuda on Refugees. 1944. Assassination of Lord Moyne in Cairo. 1945. President Truman supports the demand for a large number of immigrants to Palestine. 1946. Truman supports demand for admission of 100,000 refugees to Palestine. This is refused by the British. Jewish sabotage operations throughout Palestine. Irgun blows up King David Hotel in Jerusalem. Truman endorses partition of Palestine and creation of a Jewish state. 1947. British Foreign Secretary Ernest Bevin declares intention to refer the Palestine mandate back to the United Nations. General Assembly votes for partition of Palestine into a Palestinian and a Jewish state. The British government expresses its intention to terminate its responsibility under the mandate. 1948. Irgun, led by Menachem Begin, massacre villagers at Deir Yassin. Palestinian civilians flee en masse, fearing a similar fate. Ben-Gurion declares the State of Israel. Termination of the British Mandate. Arab armies enter areas assigned to the Palestinian state under the partition plan to support Palestinian resistance. UN appoints as mediator Count Volker Bernadotte. Bernadotte assassinated. Fighting between Israel and Egypt. Moshe Dayan drives all Palestinian civilians from Lida and Ramla by force. UN Resolution 194 states that Palestinian refugees wishing to return to their homes should be permitted to do so, and that compensation for loss or damage to property should be paid. 1949. Israel concludes armistice agreements with Egypt, Lebanon, and Syria. UN votes in favour of internationalizing Jerusalem. Ben-Gurion declares Jerusalem the capital of Israel. 1950. Beginning of immigration to Israel of Jews from Arab countries. King Abdullah of Jordan formally annexes the West Bank. The law of return gives the right to settle in Israel to every Jew worldwide. 1951. King Abdullah assassinated in Jerusalem at Friday prayers. 1952. Coup in Egypt by free officers. Rise to power of Nasser. 1953. Ben-Gurion retires. Moshe Sharet becomes Prime Minister of Israel. 1954. Increased Fedayeen attacks on Israel. Israeli army attacks Nahalin in the West Bank. 1955. Israel launches major raid against Egyptians. Military pact between Egypt and Syria. Ben-Gurion becomes Prime Minister. 1956. Israel attacks in Sinai. Israeli border guards massacre 49 villagers at Kufr Qasim. UN Security Council resolution calling for Israeli withdrawal from Sinai vetoed by Britain and France. British and French attack in the Canal Zone. 1957. Israel announces intention conditionally to withdraw from Sinai. Palestinian Liberation Party, Fatah, founded. 1958. Relations between Israel and United States strengthened. 1963. Levi Eshkol becomes Prime Minister. 1964. Palestinian Liberation Organization, PLO, founded. 1966. Fedayeen activity against Israel increased. 1967. Nasser sends troops into Sinai. Nasser closes Strait of Tehran to Israeli shipping. Six-Day War. Summit at Khartoum. United Nations Security Council Resolution 242 issued. 1968. Golda Meir becomes Prime Minister. Egypt commences war of attrition against Israel. Yasser Arafat elected chairman of the Executive Committee of the PLO. 1970. Black September. Jordanian army acts against PLO guerrillas in Jordan. 1971. PLO guerrillas leave Jordan for Syria and South Lebanon. 1972. Black September organization seizes Israeli athletes at Munich Olympics. 9 Israelis die in airport shootout. 1973. Egypt and Syria launch full-scale war against Israeli forces occupying the Sinai Peninsula and Golan Heights. 1974. Summit meeting of Arab leaders in Rabat declares the PLO the only legitimate representative of the Palestinian people. 1975. Civil war breaks out in Lebanon. Palestinian guerrillas fight alongside Lebanese leftists and Muslims against Maronite Christians. 1976. Following Syrian intervention in the Lebanese civil war, Arab leaders agree to a ceasefire. 1977. Sadat goes to Jerusalem for peace offer. 1978. Israel invades South Lebanon and attacks Palestinian guerrilla bases. Camp David Accord signed by Egypt, Israel, and USA. 1979. Egypt and Israel sign peace treaty. 1981. Katyusha war between the PLO and Israel in Lebanon. Sadat assassinated by Egyptian militants during a military parade celebrating victory in the 1973 war. 1982. Israel invades Lebanon again in an all-out offensive against the PLO. Israeli forces reach outskirts of Beirut. Following the siege, the PLO leaves Lebanon, establishes headquarters in Tunis, and scatters its fighters throughout the Arab countries. Massacre of Palestinian refugees in Sabra and Shatila camps in Lebanon. Israeli Defense Minister Sharon forced from office. Lebanon-Israel truce. 1985. Israeli Air Force attack on PLO headquarters in Tunis. Palestinian Liberation Front hijacks Akililoro in the Mediterranean. Palestinian Intifada begins in the Israeli-occupied Gaza Strip and the West Bank. Khalil al-Wazir, Abu Jihad, assassinated by Israeli commandos in Tunis. Jordanian disengagement from the West Bank. Palestinian National Council declares an independent Palestinian state. Arafat recognizes Israel and renounces terrorism before the UN at Geneva. USA agrees to open dialogue. Mass migration of Soviet Jews to Israel begins. 1990. Iraq invades Kuwait. 1991. Gulf War. Allied bombing campaign against Iraq. Middle East Peace Conference in Madrid. 1992. Labour Party under Rabin wins Israeli election and engages the PLO in dialogue. 1993. PLO Declaration of Principles on Interim Self-Government. 1994. Jewish settler Baruch Goldstein murders Palestinian Muslims worshipping at Hebron Mosque. Cairo Agreement between Israel and PLO. Israel-Jordan Peace Treaty. White House lawn handshake between Rabin, Peres and Arafat, who are jointly awarded the Nobel Peace Prize. Israeli forces commence withdrawal from Jericho and the Gaza Strip. 1995. Rabin assassinated by Jewish extremist at a peace rally in Tel Aviv. 1996. Benjamin Netanyahu becomes Prime Minister. 1998. Y River Agreement between Netanyahu and Arafat. 1999. Netanyahu loses Israeli election to Ehud Barak. King Hussein of Jordan dies and is succeeded by his elder son, Abdullah. 2000. Israel withdraws from Lebanon. Death of President Hafez al-Assad of Syria. Palestinian uprising.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.